Hi, I'm Beth with 50 Plus Beauty, and I'm excited that you're here with me today to share some great information about our skin. And it's something that totally took me by surprise, but I guess it shouldn't have. I have always said my favorite climate is air conditioning, and I absolutely hate being out in the heat. So for many years, I've run from air-conditioned house to air-conditioned car to air-conditioned workplace. I just did not like being out in the heat. Turns out that has been a very good decision for my skin. And I'll get into that information in just a minute, but if you're not a subscriber, I hope you'll subscribe and click that little bell. We have lots of great anti-aging, youthing skincare here, and also hair and makeup tips too. Now, with my girlfriends, anytime I read something in a book or magazine, I'm always the first to kind of run to them and share it with them. And you guys are no exception to me. I wanted to share this article that I found. It was in the June edition, this month's edition of Shape Magazine. And I threw the magazine away. I get so many magazines and they just build up. So I rip out the articles I would really like to keep and then I toss the magazines away. But this article is called Your Skin Hates Heat. Your Skin Hates Heat. And it is about the newest research about heat in our skin. And as it turns out, temperatures outside of around the 100 degree mark or more, or taking hot showers, is really not good for our skin. Let me show you what the research has found. Here are some skin heat facts. When you're out in the heat, it causes your blood vessels to dilate, and that increases inflammation. And that can lead to broken blood vessels. In fact, I've always had broken blood vessels around my nose, and maybe that's in part due to exposure to heat. And it also increases the melanocytes. And the melanocytes actually increase pigmentation in your skin. So the heat can cause broken blood vessels and increase pigmentation. It can also break down antioxidants, and it causes an increase in a specific protein which leads to the breakdown of collagen. And this can lead to fine lines and wrinkles. As our collagen decreases, our skin becomes less plump, and those fine lines and wrinkles just sag in and become more prominent. Now, knowing this, there are certain steps we can take to decrease the impact of heat on our skin, and here they are. The first thing is to wear a physical sunblock. That is a sunblock that's non-chemical that contains zinc or titanium dioxide. The reason you want to use a physical sunblock is because chemical sunscreens actually produce a chemical reaction in your skin that actually heats up the skin and can cause hyperpigmentation. Another thing you can do is to wear mineral foundations because they cool skin. If you happen to like mineral foundations, wear hats and sunglasses because that cools the temperature of your face. Also, if you're going to jog or exercise in the outside, do it in the morning or the evening, not in the intense part of the day where the sun is most hot. Also, avoid saunas, steam rooms, and hot tubs because they definitely heat up the skin, which is not good for our skin. And when you're taking your shower or bath, try to avoid hot showers and baths. Instead, use more tepid, cooler water. And drink cool, icy drinks on hot days because that does tend to bring down the body temperature. And wherever possible, on super hot days, stay inside. And remember, the air conditioner is your friend. So during these hot summer months, let's all of us take better care of our skin. Always wear sunblock every day and also try to keep out of the heat. Now, I always like to leave you with a little thought for the day, and today is no exception. I'm going to be choosing a card from the Power Thoughts cards by Louise Hay, and this will be a power thought, hopefully. Let's see what this is. Ooh, my life is a mirror. My life is a mirror. The people in my life are really mirrors of me. This affords me the opportunity to grow and change. You know, I really do believe this. In my first half, I spent a lot of time kind of perceiving myself as the victim. I would say, oh, that person is being mean to me, and oh, I feel so bad because why are they so mean and negative towards me? But then in my second half, I realized if I'm experiencing meanness and negativity around me, it's usually because it's coming out of my own heart and it's being projected outward. Because I truly believe that the people around us are actually mirrors of what's going on right in our own hearts. That means when we go through our days and we look at the people around us and they seem kind, generous, and lighthearted, that generally means that we're feeling that way too. So friends, just for today, let's look at the people around us as mirrors of what's going on in our own hearts, and let's try to use that information to learn and grow. Take care. See you next time.